Hi guys. Welcome back. I hope that all of you are safe and well. I'm very late to the pandemic party, but I'd like to share my thoughts nonetheless, if you're up for it. There are three things that I'd like to discuss, as read in the title. First of all, I want to talk about the virus itself. Secondly, I'd like to talk about the vaccine. And finally, I'd like to talk about the future implications of past actions taken against the virus. I'll mostly be sharing my opinion, aided by the fact that I work closely with the vaccines. So I'm merely expressing my thoughts, please keep that in mind. But without any further delay, let's dive right into the video, starting with the little bat that caused all of this. When I first heard about the outbreak in early 2020, I wasn't concerned, since the causative virus is a common one. When I found out that the then new strain has the potential to cause SARS, even though SARS as complication of the virus is rare, it is the precise thing that gives the virus its lethality rate. The immune deficient and elderly are among the most vulnerable to succumb to this disease, which brings me to my next point. The vaccine. I was one of the first few thousand to get the vaccine. Please stop calling a jab, it makes me cringe. Anyway, many people ask me why I got the vaccine and now they have me asking the same question, which is one of the reasons why I decided to make this video. I didn't get the vaccine and its booster for myself. I could have easily beaten this thing had it come my way, but I have people at home who might not have immune systems quite as strong as mine. These are people I love and care about, and they are too stubborn to get the vaccine, so I went and got it instead. I did it to protect them. On a quick side note, why did people actually think microchips are being put in vials? How do you expect 5 or 6 people, depending on the type of vaccine, to each only receive one chip from their shared vial? That's not how it works. The only way this would work is if the chip is inserted after a dose has been drawn from the vial. And I don't ever remember adding microchips to the prepared syringes. And to think some people actually believe this myth to this day. The stupidity of the general population scares me sometimes. Getting back to my point, I was afraid to get vaccinated because of all the stories I heard and possible side effects that could be serious. I, a medical professional, was afraid of myths spread around by the gen pop. Let that sink in. Nevertheless, I got vaccinated and experienced only mild side effects. Luckily, serious side effects like anaphylaxis are rare. So rare, in fact, that I have indirectly observed over 17,000 vaccinations and I haven't been handed even a single ADR form or had an emergency reorder of epinephrine come in. At this point, as a bystander, it is difficult to accurately keep track of exactly how many people have been vaccinated, since there are boosters and different doses and protocols for different individuals. But my closest estimate of the vaccination rate of my local district is about 35%. Since the launch of the vaccination campaign, the vaccination rate has climbed dramatically, but just as significantly as it rose, it fell back down. And this is not just because of the festive season. It seems that those who are willing to get the vaccine have already been vaccinated. Is it really possible that vaccine hesitancy is this high? Could it be possible that we as a species could be progressing backwards? And this brings me to my final point and something that concerns me greatly, the aftermath of the pandemic. More specifically, the economic future of humanity. Because of the lockdown in 2020, and all the spending on PPE and vaccine research and development, the future worries me, which is the other reason that made me want to make this video. As an express for concern, the way I understand the economy, banks are too big to fail and can just print more money when they start running dry. But this causes inflation. 2% annually is fine, but 10% is not. And with that in mind, I think we can all agree that the world governments have spent a shit ton of money on the virus in the past 2 years. As if depreciation of capital value isn't enough, the lockdown affected all industries and trades, and caused the collapse of an uncountable amount of businesses, which caused a statistically significant increase in unemployment rates, which also decreases the amount of tax income for a country. I'm no expert in chemistry. Well, technically I am, but I'm guessing inflation and unemployment don't mix well. These two consequences bother me the most, seeing as how I'll be jobless in 16 days. Everyone is counting down to Christmas, while I'm here dreading the thought of walking that line. Nevertheless, there are other consequences of the actions taken against the virus. These are things like food shortages, production line halts. The cinematic, sports and tourism industries have taken a hard hit in the buzz in 2020. If you owned a liquor store before all of this, you probably don't anymore. Press F in the comments to pay respect to all the startup companies that failed due to the 2020 lockdown. But apparently, plastic surgery is booming amidst the pandemic. I guess some people think that if the virus can't recognize you, it can't hurt you. I'll never understand humans. Before I go, I want to remind everyone that I'm not forcing anyone to do anything. My main goal is to express my thoughts, not influence yours. But whether you get vaccinated or not, please be mindful of others, as their immune systems might not be as strong as yours and the consequences for them might be severe. So please wash your hands. There's nothing wrong with a little extra soap and water, unless you like it dirty. You weirdo. Anyway guys, I think that I'm going to end it here. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Leave a like if you enjoyed or a dislike if you didn't, and remember to stay safe, stay awesome. Until next time. Peace.